this is a story set against a huge backdrop, but really it's about these three characters, this odd family. Can you talk a little bit about the connection between this central trio and what it was like working with Henry and Anna?
Well, they are linked by destiny. And I think ultimately in the end, although we haven't explored it yet, they require something from each other. And that's why they are a three, because they're going to get something from one another. And they all have a commonality as well. They're all orphans. They all, something in them wants a family. I think that's what's going to be really special when we get to explore that.
Fantasy genres, we often see princesses. I'm curious what that label means to you and how important it was for you that this character isn't defined by that and perhaps, is so much more.
I mean, I understand that she is so much more than a princess, and she certainly doesn't want to be restricted by the typical conformity that comes with being a princess. However, it is a big part of who she is. That's where she's been born. She's been born as a princess. She's looked up to her grandmother, who is the queen, Calanthe. And so it is, I don't think it is something necessarily to be brushed under the carpet. I think it is a big part of who she is. I think she takes pride in that because of her grandmother. But yes, it is important to see that she is not going to be restricted by the stereotypical conformity that comes with being a princess. She wants to break free from that. She wants to fight. She wants to get involved. She wants to raise her voice. She's not going to be suppressed or told what she should and shouldn't do. She wants to take her future into her own hands, which is what I love about her. She learns so much about herself and she changes so much, and it's emphasised by her environment and by the brutality of what she's experiencing, that I think that heightens her growth. She has to grow quicker than how she would have if she was still a princess.